pain. The struggle of the first round here is between higher and lower mind, and the battleground will be the causal body point creator. 38 with causal body. This influence or force, or result, or whatever it may be called, of the antecedent actions of man, forms as it were a seed, from which germinates the plant, and even good or bad fruit, may even by enduring his subsequent existence.
Yeah.
downwards. Perhaps in summing up, it might be expressed thus. The originating source of manic activity in the solar system is that great cosmic entity who embodies our solar logo with the center in his body, along with six other solar logoi who are, in their totality, his seven centers. The originating source of manic activity in the planetary schemes is that cosmic entity we call the solar logo. He is the active, directing intelligence who is working with definite purpose through his seven centers. The originating source of manifest principle in a planetary scheme is that lesser cosmic entity whom we call a planetary logo. He works through his seven chains of the logos through his seven planetary centers. It is interesting here to note that when the solar logos is being manically impelled to work out some purpose of his greater source, the one about whom not may be said, he may cause a vivification in one or other of his centers according to the purpose in view. This occurred in the forming of the triangle of which Earth and Venus are two points, and affecting 394 ATREATISCONCOSMICFIRE. The heavenly men of these two schemes stimulated them to take initiation, and led the planetary logos of our scheme to form a lesser triangle within his sphere of activity, which triangle eventuated in his taking a lesser initiation, and in the manic impregnation of animal man. Thus were swept into objective activity the group of monads who go to the composition of a particular center. Similarly, and microcosmically, a human being is the manic incentive and the origin of active, intelligent will to all the cells within his threefold body, astral, mental and physical. This is the directing intelligence, and is the source of all action and endeavor within his periphery, and, like his greater corresponding spheres, a solar logo and a planetary logos, he works through seven centers. Thus we have traced the origin of manas as far as it is possible to do in this time. The mystery of manas is hidden in existence itself, and holds the secret of life and conceals and veils those entities whose outstanding quality and characteristic it is. To the life of that little entity we call an atom in the physical body of a man, the thinker in the causal body, greater directing intelligence, it is obscure and unknown as the logos as to the thinker, man, himself. The analogy is nevertheless accurate. 0.39 man's physical body, for instance, considering it 39 form. The Atharva Veda, at the formation, instructs us in the principle underlie the methods of the world process, and of the atom processor wherein in miniature. Whether world processor or atom process depends on the speaker at this point of view. As every monitoring is made and reflects the operations of the world process, so is the not self. Intelligence. Manas. The relation of being. THEFACTORFMANAS 397. Abstruse matter can be made clear, and to indicate certain lines of investigation which might be strenuously and scientifically followed, yield to the speed of the metroid of knowledge. Until the intuition is better developed in the average man, the very principle of Manas itself forms a barrier to his true understanding. 2. Manas and karmic purpose. If it is realized by the student that Manas and intelligent purpose are practically synonymous terms, it will be immediately apparent that karma and the activities of the world will be involved in the matter. It will also be apparent that only if the lower mind is transmuted into the abstract or higher mind and commenced into the intuition, will man be able to understand the significance of Manas. Perhaps that's why this must be so. Surely it is because the abstract mind is the agent on cognitive levels whereby the entity concerned formulates its plans and purposes. These plans and purposes conceived within the abstract mind in due course of evolution crystallize into concrete form by means of the concrete mind. What we call the archetypal plane is connection with the logos, the plane whereon he forms his ideas, his aspiration and his abstract conception, and your remote correspondence to the atomic abstract levels of the mental plane, from whence are initiated the impulses and purposes of the spirit and man, those purposes which eventually force him into an objective form, thus paralleling the form of manifestation. First, the abstract concept and the medium provided for manifestation is form, and finally, that form itself. Such is the process for gods and for men, and in it is hidden the mystery of mind and of its place in evolution. For the sake of clarity, let us take a microcosm for momentary study. It should be realized by all students that man is spirit and is self, working through matter with ATREATISC on cosmic fire. The not self, by means of the intelligence for Manas, and it should also be realized that the statement of this fact is easily true of the solar logo, a heavenly man, and a human being involved. manifest